Houston, we have a problem. I'd like to welcome you all to Bess, who is she came to live with blah blah blah. She came to live with us yesterday. Her owner sadly passed away, and she needed a new home. So she's doing really, really well. You can see she's feeling quite calm and settled here. She's considering she's in a whole new environment, a different town, different home, with people that I don't think she's ever met before. She's settling it really, really well. She's causing a nuisance. She's been chasing my crystals. You can see she's doing it again there, chasing my crystals around. She's having quite a, I think it's playtime for her. I tried to move her onto the window ledge, but she came back. She's funny. She's funny. I'm happy she's here. She's doing super well. Yeah, I guess I'll get back to your reading once she decides to move. I'm just going through my notes because so far the songs that have come through for you are Always Gold by the acoustic version by Radical Face. I don't really know that song very well. I don't quite know how it ended up on my likes, but it did. Maybe Don't by Maisie Peters and JP Saxe. And the randomised song that I just got for you on Spotify was I Got Trouble by Christina Aguilera. And it's like, I got trouble, trouble, trouble. I've got trouble, haven't I? Haven't I, Bess? You're my trouble. Always knocking at my door. Now, that song came out for another sign recently because I remember singing it. Or trying to sing it with my not great singing voice. And there's been all this stuff about kind of like vintage kind of screen sirens coming through. Sorry about that, like literally a siren. I was just saying screen sirens and that siren noise came through. So this is like a reoccurring theme for me. Please don't nudge my tripod, Bess. So I'm not quite sure what's going on with that. I'm just kind of looking back through my notes. I tried looking back through a few videos, but I've not found who it came out for yet. I'm just going to look back at Cancer because Cancer was the main sign last week that was getting all this kind of screen siren business. Oh, it was Cancer. I Got Trouble, Christina Aguilera. Yeah, so Taurus, you may be connecting with a Cancer. You may have Cancer placements in your chart. I also felt like in Pisces reading, this energy was coming through again. So there may be something going on where between a Pisces, a Taurus, and a Cancer, there may be something going on with maybe something to do with the planets. Now, Taurus, you actually have today on the 29th, when I'm recording this, the huge slow-moving planet of Saturn is actually it's been in retrograde through Capricorn recently, and it's actually just starting to go direct now. It's sorry, fluffy cattail on the screen. Yeah, so it's major. It's major. Saturn. It takes something about like 30 years for this. For this big slow-moving planet to do a full circuit through all the signs, this going retrograde in Capricorn has been resulting in this kind of like people kind of questioning authority, questioning structures in the life, questioning routines, roles, things that are restricting, social conventions, all these kind of things. Taurus, this reminds me of the Hierophant card, which is actually your card. Thank you, Bess, for messing up all my cards. They were so neat and tidy before you decided to start rolling around. And maybe this is actually teaching us something. Maybe this is teaching us that no matter how much we try to impose rules and regulations and procedures and social conventions on people, on the world, there's always the kind of free radicals, the Lokis, the cats of the world, in whatever shape or form that comes in for us. They come in and they just do what they want and mess things up, mess up the best laid plans, right, Taurus? Perhaps you're dealing with someone like that at the moment. But this is meant to happen. Planetarily speaking, this is meant to happen. Saturn is transiting through Capricorn and it's going to go into Aquarius. And Aquarius is all about doing things differently, innovating. Hello, beautiful. Innovation, kind of shaking things up, moving things forward, kind of questioning those conventions of Saturn in Capricorn, to do things a little bit differently, to improve the systems, to make things more fair, rather than the Capricorn, Saturn in Capricorn energy, which is quite controlling, sort of to do with like the powers that be, the authority in our lives, whether that be like religion or politics. Aquarius is the more humanitarian sign that makes things fairer, that makes things, that shares the power, that shares the decision making. So it's really interesting energy, and I thought I'd talk about it today with you being the Taurus and the Hierophant card, with this change happening on the day of your reading. I feel like everything is meant to be. Everything is. Where are you going? You know, cats are liquid. They can squeeze into all these strange, unexpected places. She's hiding behind a set of drawers now. So I think this might be a good time, actually, for me to get into the energies, get that one more song for you from Spotify, and then we can get into your reading. And hopefully she's not going to come and roll all over the cards, but she probably will, because that is meant to happen, Taurus, and we just have to put up with it. Here she comes back. I'll be back with you in a few minutes, Taurus. Okay, Taurus, so I've managed to re-establish some sense of order to the chaos that Bess is causing to my cards, to my reading. Your other song was Message in a Bottle by The Police. So The Police sending out an SOS, asking for help. You've got I Got Trouble, asking for help. Perhaps you've got trouble and you're asking other people for help, or you need to ask other people for help. Something's gone wrong. There's, what they're trying to give me is a phrase. I can't get the phrase, but it's coming through as Wire in the Blood, which was, I think, a TV show. It's like a stick in the cogs. I can't think of the phrase that I'm trying to think of, but it's coming through as Wire in the Blood. Perhaps something to do with the amount of metal you've got in your blood, for somebody. Wire in the Blood. What does that mean? So one of the signs last week was getting something about a mechanical heart. Like the heart was a human heart. It was like a squishy heart, but it was in like a machine casing. It was like a reverse Iron Man. So there's something to do with like maybe that's coming back through for you. Maybe you're dealing with this, whatever this is as well. Wire in the Blood. There's some sort of problem. I've got trouble. Dealing with a trouble causer, asking for help. Take that as it resonates, leave it if it doesn't. Something about establishing control and order. Perhaps somebody's a police officer or dealing with the police, or they have a police officer in the family, they know a police officer. Law and Order, the TV show. All these things. Also, I'm sort of being reminded, on Saturday evening, now I don't do a reading on Sunday morning, so I forgot to sort of mention this for Aries's reading, but I feel like I forgot on purpose because it might be a message for you. So if on Saturday you were having ice cream, either strawberry ice cream or something with raspberry syrup, I could really, really strongly smell either that kind of fake, like fruit smell, like either fake strawberry ice cream or fake, like, like raspberry syrup, that kind of. It's not really fruit, it's like the sugar smell. I could smell it really, really strongly. Oh my God, I can smell it again. Is it Jostic? I'm like eating a dragon's blood Jostic, but it shouldn't smell like. No, it's a different smell. So that's a message for someone. Someone's had strawberry ice cream or raspberry syrup. So there may be something important in this reading for you. Just channeling in because I forgot to do that. Just start talking. Bess is currently on the bed. She's just having a little rest on the bed now. So hopefully she stays there and gives us a moment of peace. Okay, talking of peace, maybe you need to meditate. I'm just going to tune into the energies on camera now. Okay, so we're going for the message for Taurus or those coming to this reading today that's going to do the most good. Okay, so what do Taurus or the people coming to this video need to know, please? What's going on for Taurus? What message would you like to communicate today, please? Taurian energy, what message would you like to communicate today, please? Thank you. And the underlying, we've got caught in the ruins. So somebody may be trapped in a situation that's kind of failing. It's like the ruins of a situation. It's like the tower moment has come in. There's been some kind of shock, some kind of revelation, something that's kind of like changed the way that you look at things, but you're still trapped in that place. It could be, as an example, it doesn't have to be this. It could be like you're in a relationship and the relationship is falling apart and you know it's falling apart but you haven't left it yet. Or it could be like a workplace, same situation with a workplace. You know that the ship's going down. I don't know why they're giving me it as like a nautical reference. Perhaps some of you have a nautical something to do with like boats or ships, or perhaps somebody in your family was a sailor. Perhaps that's why this is coming through. The ship's going down, and you're still caught in the ruins. You feel like you can't escape this yet. But what you're not seeing about this card though is that, oh, look at that underneath as well. I was talking about ships and like the sea reflection. Oh my God, look as well. And these things happen for a reason, okay? This is not an accident. I was talking about boats, nautical. We got this picture of like a nautical setting with a boat there, reflection. You may have to reflect on a situation. Now you can see I've picked up two cards. Now they didn't want me to look at this card underneath. They've made me pick up two cards on purpose because the next card has a ship on it, the lookout. And I was saying about, is the ship's going down, right? There may be a commitment here. That you're leaving. You made a commitment, there may be a contract here. You feel like you can't leave yet, something to do with this contract that you've signed, perhaps a marriage contract, work contract, take it as it resonates, house, mortgage. You are kind of feeling a bit trapped in a situation. What's the word? I can't think of the word. Litigation, they're trying to give me litigationally. That doesn't make sense, but that's how it's coming through. But the ship's going down, it's burning. You're on the lookout for some other opportunity. You're trying to figure out how to climb out of this situation. You can see here these people look like they're trapped, but actually the wall's kind of down on this side. They, with a bit of effort, they could probably climb out of that. You know, they could climb the bars, climb over the wall. It is possible to get out of this situation, but perhaps you're just not seeing how yet. Just to have a look at what that card was. The journey. Oh my goodness, more ships. You can see as well these people, this like woman and child, are ready to get into the boat here. They're not all ships in this pack. There's definitely a nautical reference here for somebody. Somebody may be literally needing to get on a boat. Somebody may work in some kind of industry that deals with boats. It may be an ancestor that has something to do with boats. I know that my one of my ancestors, he was like my great 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 granddad's brother. He was on the Lusitania, the sister ship of the Titanic, I think it was. Was it? Or no, it wasn't. It was a different it was a different company. There's the White Star Line, isn't there? And then there's the what's the other one? I don't know. Perhaps this is a reason that I can only think of one and not the other. But there was the Lusitania that was coming back from America to England, and it was off the coast of Ireland. Reportedly, the official line of what happened was that it was torpedoed by the Germans during the war. And there was a big outcry because it was a passenger ship, and people thought that Germany shouldn't have done that. And so that actually brought America into the war. So people think there's some kind of conspiracy behind that. It's a whole thing. You can go down Wikipedia rabbit hole and go and look that up. But what I'm trying to get to is that my ancestor was actually on the ship when it went down, and he survived barely. He got sucked down into a stairwell. The water kind of suctioned him down a stairwell. He almost drowned. He was kind of bobbing in the water, and I think he was a steward. Was on one of the lifeboats searching for survivors, and somebody said, oh, just he's gone, he's dead, that guy, leave him. But the steward was like, no, we're gonna fish him out. Got him, luckily he did survive. So yeah, I don't know, why am I telling you this? It may be important. Maybe you've watched the film Titanic recently. There's something going on here. There's a reason why I'm waffling on about this, and there's all this nautical references, and nothing nothing, everything that comes through is supposed to come through. It's going to mean something to someone. So if it's not your message, just leave it. But there's going to be someone here who's going, oh my God, that is exactly, oh my God. That makes so much sense. So yeah, exactly. Everything comes through for a reason. I'm waffling on for a reason. Something is trying to be communicated to you here through all this waffle. For some of you, it is just, the general story, the surface level, surface again, surface of the water, reflection on the surface of the water. What are they giving me? why am I so excitable? There's a situation that's coming to an end, and it might be coming to a bit of a stormy end. Yesterday, Aries was getting all this storm warning business through. It's like rocking the boat, right? The boat has already been rocked. There may be a situation where somebody, you are trying to stabilize the situation, I think, with the cat, what that was giving me before. You're trying to stabilize the situation. You're trying to keep control. You're trying to navigate the situation to keep the boat moving forward, to keep the boat afloat. You're like, right, we can do this. If everybody just grabs an oar, do as you're told. If you will grab an oar, if you lot kind of bail the water out, we can get through this, we can sail this to shore. But you're trying to control the uncontrollable. SOS, sending out an SOS, message in a bottle. It's all kind of, it's all making sense, but it's not making sense. Kind of, there's the connections there, but I don't understand what it means. Perhaps you do, or somebody here knows exactly what this means. Sending out an SOS, the ship's going down, you're trying to make it land safely at shore, but like, you can't control the controllable. They're like cats, right? They're not following orders. They've all got their own ideas. They're all trying to do their own thing. And it's frustrating because you're like, I can see how to make this successful, but you can't make the people do as they're told. So the ship is going to go down. So how are you going to get out? You're caught in the ruins. How are you going to get out of this situation? The ship is on fire. Reflection, commitment, contract. Okay. Okay. Right, well, maybe that's a side message just for one person, the way that all came through, because that isn't even the cards that came out. That's a whole thing by itself. I don't know how I'm going to do this reading today. So Buddha, the Buddha prepares. So yeah, maybe you need to prepare for this. So again, if that's not your situation, just leave it. Okay, so I'm going to start again. For some of you, this ties into that previous situation. For some of you, this is the start of this story for you. So one and three makes a four. Four's about foundations. So the Buddha prepares. There's a need to be, with the reflection card, there's a need to kind of be tranquil. It's interesting that I did my tuning in on camera. I did it quite quickly. There is a sense of feeling quite rushed. There's a sense of urgency, Taurus, to your reading today. A sense of things not going quite according to plan. So yeah, make sure you take a little bit of time to perhaps take a few breaths to ground yourself, prepare yourself mentally and emotionally for what is to come, because I feel like there is some kind of new birth coming here. I don't think this is something that you can fight with the I was talking about Saturn is moving forwards now in Capricorn into Aquarius eventually, and there's other big planets as well that have been moving through Capricorn into Aquarius as well. It's huge. Basically, the alignment of the planets now and this transition is quite big and revolutionary. So there's a lot of things that are going to old ways of doing things that are going to get shaken up. It's like birthing a new world. It's big energy. So Taurus, with you being the Hierophant, you are probably one of the people who this is going to hit quite hard. You may be one of the people who really try to resist it. You really try to impose your control over a situation. But what you have to understand is things are meant to change. It's written in the stars. Traditions are meant to be shaken up right now, and trying to cling to them is only going to make the ride bumpier for you. So if these things are happening and you can't control it, I think perhaps you're starting to realize now, I can't control this situation, I'm losing control. Start planning ahead, right? So think, okay, maybe I can save this situation, but if it doesn't, what am I going to do? So the Buddha prepares. Okay, so there's this sense, it's trying to give you this sense of calm, this sense of going with the flow, like literally going where like the rivers take you, where the tides take you, but planning ahead. Okay, so what things can I do? Have plans in place of what you can do if that ship does go down. Be calm, understand that it's happening for a reason, because it's trying to birth in this new world or this new way of doing things that's actually ultimately going to be better for everybody. You may still find that you are still in a position of leadership because you are Taurus. That's kind of your purpose, is to be in positions where you can steer the boat, okay? So you may find that you're steering a different boat, whatever that means to you, whether you're the head of a different company, the head of a different household, or you stay with the company, but the company changes in some way. But it is ultimately meant to happen for the good. And again, we've got another for number four. So 1 and 3 make 4. This is a 4. Fours are all about stable foundations, about really laying the ground, like doing the groundwork for some kind of new situation. So this is what you are supposed to be doing right now as these planets move. You're meant to be doing the groundwork, setting things up, making sure the foundations are stable for the new things that come in. This is your purpose, Taurus. Again, there are a lot of Taurians out there. I do encourage you to go and look at your full birth chart, because some people will have different placements, which mean that some people are more typically Taurian energy, where other people may have contradictory placements, which mean that the kind of typical Taurian stereotypes may not fit you as well. So for example, if you're Taurus but you have a lot of Aquarius in your chart, you're going to be more likely to think outside the box, more likely to find it easy to try new things, more likely to kind of think as in a kind of a way that kind of encourages and supports those beneath you, rather than just kind of being a bit bullheaded and thinking about the plan in front of you. You may think a little bit more, be a bit more considerate of those around you. And that's not me calling out any Taurians. All signs have positive aspects and negative aspects. So I'm just trying to help. I can see the value in you, because you are one of the signs that's really good at doing this kind of like foundation work, this groundwork, putting procedures in place, so that it's almost like doing a fire drill. This is what they're giving me now. It's like when you're at work and you do the fire drill, you do the fire practices. What happens if there is an emergency? What do we all do? So somebody has thought ahead and said, right, well, if this happens, this is the procedure. I need to make sure everybody knows that this is the procedure to follow. So this is like what you've done, or this is what you're doing, or you need to do. You're like, right, okay, if this happens, what plan do we all follow? If this happens, what plan do we all follow? And then doing kind of like drills or practicing what happens in the future. It's like this preparation energy of what happens if something goes wrong, what happens if the unexpected happens. Yeah, Taurus, this is your job. This is what you're good at. This is what everybody needs from you, because some people they flow through life, they don't think about these things, they've got their own stuff to deal with, but you're the person who puts those plans in place. So yes, things might change, but you're the one that plans for what happens when the things do change, when the tower moment happens. Does that make sense to you? It's a really strong message coming through. It's like, it feels really important. It's like, okay, the ship's going down. Who's sending the SOS signal? How do they send the SAS signal? Who do they send it to? What does everybody else do? Like, this is what they're saying about, like, you're the one that's going, right, you lot get on the oars. You lot bail the water out of the ship. It may be something to do with your ancestors. Look at this, Hilarion and the Akashic Library here. I was just about to say this may be something to do with your ancestors here. And I was talking about how my ancestor was on the Lusitania when it went down. I think the boat stuff is a metaphor for whatever situation you're in. So I can't believe you had that sending out an SOS, and now it all makes sense. Because at first I was like, is this the song that's meant to come through? Maybe I should skip it and get the next song. But now I'm like, so glad I didn't, because it makes perfect sense. For some reason, I'm noticing the archway on this court in the ruins and the archway of this window here. So there may be some archway that's relevant to you. Turning maybe a door, right? Okay, what they're telling me is a door is closed, but it's turning into a window. So maybe somebody is actually bricking up. Is that what it is? Okay, that might be it for somebody. Perhaps in your workplace, you've got your oh my god, look at the hearing the alarm. For some of you, it's something like you are in a workplace, you're in a building, and there used to be a fire exit somewhere. But that fire exit is now not a door anymore. It's not an exit. Perhaps there's been some renovation work where that's not, people can't get out there anymore, right? The door has turned into a window. The gate is locked. So what it's telling me is that you might have to go through and check the things like, where do the fire exit signs point to? Do they all point to that place where people are going to get trapped now? It's like the show me kind of like people running through a building and getting trapped because they can't get out that way anymore. They might have to like smash the window to get out. So you need to look at that. And has there been any revelation? Perhaps this is a revelation for you. Perhaps you're going, oh my God, I never thought of that. Yeah, people are going to get trapped because that's not a fire exit anymore. It's something like that. And there's fire on that card as well, look. See how the angels try to protect us? See how they give us the messages that are like, look, dumbasses, you need to update your fire escape procedure. We're protecting you from a disaster here. So again, this is like, I feel like this is something to do with ancestors. Perhaps you had ancestors who were sailors. Perhaps you had ancestors. What's really funny about this card is this guy here, the guy behind him, he does actually look like my ancestors. I wonder if I can find, if you just give me a second, I'm just going to pause and find one of the books. It's kind of hard to show you, but there's quite a few people on this picture. It doesn't really make it clear who's who. I think it might be this person who was possibly the person who was on the Lusitania. But you can see here, like, the similarity of the guy here and this guy here. Similar. I'm like, did the person who made this card actually use a picture of one of my ancestors when they made this card? So it's so funny to me. My dad has I think my dad has a painting on the wall. He does look very, very similar to this. So I don't know, maybe my ancestors coming through to tell us this. It's so funny. There could be like ancestors who were something to do with boating, marine, shipping, sailors, merchant navy. I've got ancestors who are in the merchant navy as well. I actually have a bit of a boating history in my family. I think a lot of people do, right? It was a major industry at one point. You may have ancestors who are trying to help you steer the ship right now, or who are trying to give you a warning here about something going on. 1 and 9 is a 10, 10s are about endings. 1 and 7 is 8, that can be something that is, it's like an ending, but it's the eternity figure. 8's the eternity figure. There could be something to do with like what goes around comes around, ancestry. 7s, you've got 2 7s there as well. 7s are about kind of fate, being led by the heavens, divine guidance. Interesting reading. Really interesting reading, Taurus. And I thought you were going to have a boring reading today, Taurus. I thought you were just going to be like, you know, getting on with it at work. How am I going to get my pentacles together? And then you've got all this business. And I've only pulled one deck. Look how many, you should see how many decks I've got here. I may not pull cards from all of them. The Akashic Library again. Akashic Library is about ancestry. So perhaps this is telling you, you need to look at your ancestry. Perhaps you need to go and do one of those DNA test thingies. Perhaps you've done one recently. Perhaps you need to go on one of the websites like ancestry.com. Not affiliated, not sponsored. Maybe they want to sponsor me. You know, I wouldn't mind a bit of money, ancestry.com. Perhaps you need to go and do some research into your ancestry to look into kind of what your ancestors did. There's definitely some kind of naval ancestry thing going on here. I could tell you another story about one of my sort of distant ancestors. I was the son of the person who was on the Lusitania. He was an interesting character, to say the least, and he had a bit of a sticky end on a boat. So interesting business there. Let's moving swiftly on from that. What that was, we don't speak about their family member anymore. I think they had good intentions. I don't think, right, okay, going into a strange place there that they probably, yeah, I don't know. Right, okay, can you give me another card, please? What's going on for Taurus? Can you give me another card for what is going on for Taurus right now? Interesting. The cave again. The cave came out for Aries yesterday. Perhaps we've got a cusper. The flame. That's an interesting one. I don't think I've ever read that card or seen that card before. The flame, the candle. Okay, be careful if you're using candles. Be very, very careful. You don't want to start a fire. The flame is coming through as like a fire starting. Firestarter by Prodigy might be relevant here. Perhaps you've got someone who's kind of like a fire starter. They're kind of coming in. I was talking about Loki and things earlier, like this energy that comes in like a chaos energy to shake things up. Chaos is a ladder. If you prepare for it, Taurus, I know it's scary for you because you tend to like tradition, but if you see it as like chaos is a ladder, if I'm aware of it, if this is your heads up, right, this is me saying to you, something's coming in for you, there's going to be a shake up, prepare for different eventualities, lay the foundations of what happens next now, and you will, you're not going to sink, you're going to swim, and you're going to ascend. You're going to be like the captain. Like if you were like a sailor, this is your time to prove yourself, yeah, it's like your time to prove yourself. You're going to, because you've got the heads up, you could be the hero and then you could be the captain next time. It's kind of giving it me like this. Really interesting. The flame. They're giving me Eternal Flame, that song, Eternal Flame. And it's interesting that I've put it with the number 8, Eternal Flame. I'm going to just write down those songs. The Storm, see, Storm Warning. The Cave, the Storm, the Vision. Why are you giving me so many cards? I'm only meant to take one from these decks. The Cave, the Storm, the Vision. Okay. I'm going to read all these and we're going to see what they say. But I'm going to pause first and write down those couple of songs for you. The cat's being very, very well behaved now. She's just napping on the bed, which might be a message to you. I think she wanted it to be playtime. It's quite early in the morning, so she'd had a big sleep through the night. I think she had a lot of energy that she kind of needed to get out of the system. So if some of you are dealing with people who are feeling a bit cooped up, perhaps, or who are children or like children, perhaps spending, it's almost like spending 5 minutes entertaining them, letting them blow off the steam, allows you to then get the things done that you need to get done. So it might be a case of like, if you're working from home and your kids are kind of climbing the walls, you're trying to like teach them at home, it's like take them to the park for half an hour, let them run around and blow off steam, and then bring them back, and then they'll be more settled and you can get on with your work. It's this kind of, I think this is a message that's trying to come through here. Okay, so the cave. The dark, the portal, the interior. Now it's interesting, it says there's a portal because there's actually a cave on this card here. You can see there's a cave at the top of this mountain. It's almost like it's a portal, like you're going in the woods and it takes you out kind of at the peak there. There's the cave, there's something in the cave, there's something watching you in the cave. There may be a sense of like intuitive knowing here with the star lit up on the forehead. That's like the third eye. But there's a cave, like something you can't speak about. Somebody's having the voice restricted. It may be that you're shutting someone down and not letting them speak, or that you're the one trying to speak but someone's not allowing you to speak, or you could just be keeping some sort of secret. Okay, right, I see what that's something's clicked there. Okay, those who are fortunate enough to find and enter the cave are forever changed. It is a place of potent power, acting both as a portal to another realm and a space for the sacred ritual and initiation. The cave is a place to return for meaningful retreat, where one can see the true self in the darkness. In esoteric teachings, the card is known to reside in the centre of the heart. Within its walls, the whispers of compassion and self-understanding can be heard. Yet because of its mystery and power, many of us fear the cave and never try to find it. We busy ourselves in the bright lights of the city, while the cavernous and dimly lit chamber calls out to us in the night. Where is your cave? You already know. Return to it and tend the fire. The flame. Okay. Eternal flame. So eternal flame, there's something here that's to do with like, it could be like a, it's almost like past life soulmate is what's coming through here. That's not going to be for everybody, but if I'm seeing it, I have to say it, because you've got ancestry stuff, eternal flame, the number 8, eternity. So I've been picking up on it for a while, sort of didn't say, because I didn't want to be saying these things if I'm hearing a crow as well now. I don't want to say these things unless I'm sure they're there, because I don't want people to kind of, I don't know, think I say it all the time, or If you say something too much, it becomes meaningless, right? So it's like I kind of wanted to be sure, and I've got that message a few times now. So yeah, for maybe just one or two of you, it's like a past life. It's like I've known you. I know you from somewhere. I've met you somewhere before. Perhaps you're like on the Titanic or something. I don't know. So I don't know why I've gone so quiet. Let's go to the storm. I'll just show you that page. There are a couple of messages at the side. Can you hear that crow? The crow is really cawing now. I just saw it swoop across the sky as well. Honestly, these readings, they get crazy, don't they? Excuse me. Okay, the storm. I don't think I read this for Aries yesterday, so I don't know why I'm just going to go with the flow of these readings this week. I don't know what I'm doing, to be honest. And maybe that's the message. Just go with the flow. You might feel like you don't know what you're doing, but, you know, follow your intuition in a situation. The chaos, the whirlwind, the disorder. Possessing an energy, much like the Taurus tower card, the storm undoes everything that is. Everything that was solid, known, and relied upon is stripped away by the winds of fate. The ground becomes the sky becomes the center, and then the center disappears. The storm is a great equalizer. Exactly. This is exactly what Saturn moving into Aquarius is doing. No matter how far we come on the path, no matter our age, wealth, or wisdom, we can't hide from its savage winds. The disturbing howls stir anxiety and make it impossible to see and think straight. You must wait it out. If you try to fight the storm, you will lose. Okay, Taurus, this is what I'm telling you, right? If you try to fight the storm, you will lose. So they're pointing to me again, being on the ship in a storm. You cannot fight the storm. You can't stop the storm from happening. The storm is the universe. It's the things that are, no matter what you think, no matter what you try and control. And this is hypothetical, right? So it might not be a storm for you, but it's this turbulent situation that you may be entering into, you may be coming out of. I don't know where this fits for you, but it could be some sort of warning that something's coming in for you. It's going to feel very, very turbulent. You can't fight it. It's meant to be. And it's the best thing to do if you're on that boat and the storm is coming in. You can scream at the sky, it's not going to stop the storm. So you have to batten down the hatches, you have to bail the water out, you have to organize people, you have to make sure you've got that plan of action for when the storm hits. What happens? What do you do? What does everybody know what they have to do? It's like literally like you could save lives here. This is how it's coming through to me. It feels really important. Okay, the vision. So I was going to do like little silly readings, and then they turn into like these really deep kind of like, right, okay, it's time to save the world, Taurus readings. Okay, so the vision. Oh, I don't think I showed you the storm, did I? Here you go. So you can pause and read the things at the side there if you want to as well. The vision, the dream, the imagined, the revealed. It is said that we are each born with a unique vision, a destiny towards which we are aimed. Taurus. It is also that said that we forget this vision the moment we are born. And then you've got all this stuff. Look at the placement of it. It's under Hilarion and the Akashic Records, the Akashic Library. Thus, we are sent on a lifelong journey of rediscovery. Such is the elusive nature of the vision. It slips away, yet it guides. It appears in strange dreams and surreal images, seemingly unattainable and preposterous. When we are connected to the vision, we carry an inspired, enchanted aliveness that others recognize. We trust the world and its synchronicities. We walk through new doors into wondrous opportunities. We all want to be near those with vision. They emit energy more potent than any elixir. When we lose connection to the vision, life becomes dull and exhausting, lacking meaning. Bring back the mystery, bring back the dreams. I've gone tingly, like all up my legs. I've gone all tingly. Again, they've got owls on that card, sort of symbolizing knowledge. I'm going to read Hilarion and the Akashic Library for you. I'm not going to use all the decks today. I feel like this is the key message that's trying to come through. So I'm going to go deeper into this rather than pulling lots of cards. So I'm going deep instead of broad, if that makes sense. Hilarion. Oh, come back. Why are you hiding? Stop hiding. Hilarion. Seen hilarious. He always makes me think he's a funny guy, this one. Seen here with spirit and the implements of study and scientific discovery, Hilarion is a powerful ascended master and a wonderful connection to the font of information that the Akashic records hold. He is the master of research, science, truth, healing, logical mind, concrete knowledge, and spirit communication. So if you've been thinking about pursuing an endeavor in these areas, now is the time to start. Like the angels and other masters, Hilarion is always available to you, and receiving this card upright is telling you that his assistance is close at hand. If you are working on a project that requires research, a strong academic approach, and attention to detail, it's full steam ahead. Full steam ahead. That's kind of almost like an old-fashioned boat term, right? Full steam ahead. It's time to open this master's energy if you have a job that involves any type of evidence detection and drawing conclusions from that discovery. Again, I was talking about police, detectives, right? Ow. Sudden migraine. Ow. These types of jobs include... some of you may be having a migraine because you're trying to like do all this discovery and stuff. It's like hurting your head. These types of jobs include scientific research, mediumship, forensic activity, the law, medical testing, and more. These and similar activities should be on the rise for you now. This is a time to bring a logical approach to all your pursuits. Hilarion is right there with you, blessing you with help, clarity, and direction. What I'm getting for this sort of generally is that it's like you could, depending on how you feel about a situation, this may be a little bit too airy-fairy for you, right? But if you are interested in ancestry, it's almost like asking Hilarion, who is kind of like, almost like the saint, angel, the ascended master, the spirit who guards the Akashic Library. This is like... the Akashic Library is like the knowledge of everything that was and everything that could be. It's kind of like ancestral records. Perhaps some of you work for a place like ancestry.com, and there are others as well, what genealogy.com, things like this. I don't even know if that's a thing. I'm not promoting one service more than others. This is just the one that's like popping into my head, the one that I'm most familiar with myself. To the Akashic Library, and it's interesting as well, like I was showing you the image that I showed you of my ancestors from a book, which is like a history of my family. I don't know, maybe you need to write a book about the history of your family. Inside a great library, candles cast a glow upon the books in the tall shelves. A sage sits thoughtfully with an open book on his table and a quill pen in his hand. Sometimes this card can indicate writing or publishing a book for you. What did I just say? But this card also symbolizes a new initiation. Perhaps that's what you feel like. You feel like you've got all these words, right? And you kind of want to write them down. It's all these thoughts, all these words, all this stuff in your head. It's giving you a headache. So actually writing it down is going to help to process those thoughts, to get it organized, to get it out of your head and onto paper. This is a message that's coming through for somebody. An ability to manifest a new life in every way. New life, birth, a new life. You have moved deeper into the Akashic records and to higher self-awareness. Further investigation may be required, but you now have a better understanding of your old motives and new purposes. Ah, it's hurting my head. Oh, is that my crown chakra? Or either my third eye chakra or my crown chakra? So you may want to go and look up those chakras and what to do, how to unblock. Because chakras can get blocked. It's like the energy passing through your body, and you may find that you've got a blockage in either your third eye chakra, which is I think your sixth chakra, or your crown chakra, which is your seventh chakra. If you're getting a lot of headaches, blurred vision, this is kind of what's happening to me at the moment. Do go and just Google it. You can Google how to unblock your chakras. Sixth and seventh, third eye and crown chakra. It is also a time of heightened intuition as well as greater self-creation. During this phase, all you have to do is add a little conscious effort to write your new records in the Akasha. To get started today, write one simple declaration about the future you wish to create and repeat it to yourself often. Then decide one thing you can do to make it happen and do it. Anything can happen now. The breadth of the landscape before you rests solely on the scope of your imagination and your will to own it. Okay, I'm going to give you that as your advice card today, Taurus. So it's going to be in the middle of your reading rather than the end of the reading, but that's just the way we're going with the flow today, okay? We're shaking things up, we're doing things differently, and that's okay. That is okay. Don't worry about the reversed. It hasn't come out in the reversed. Okay, so, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Let's get. I'm interested to see because this card's about the chakras in this deck, so I'm wondering if a chakra card might come out for you. All tied up, attachment, happy family, deceit. Okay. Anxiety. Well, no chakras. Maybe because the message has already come through, they don't need to repeat it. Okay, I'm moving on. This may be, again, this might be a completely new story for somebody. It may be the same story coming through again. What I'm going to actually do, I think, no, I was going to tidy the cards away, but we'll keep them out just in case anything comes through that is like a repeating pattern. You've got two fives here. Two and three make a five. This is a five. This is a seven. This is a four. So four's again about stability, stable foundations. This is coming through with the happy family card. I think you want to feel, whether this is literally a family for you, your home life, or this could be a workplace as well that it could apply to. It's like wanting those stable foundations, wanting to feel secure in a situation with the number four there as well. There's a rainbow there as well, which indicates healing. And again, rainbows can be to do with... people who have passed over to the other side, connecting with ancestry, hope, emotions there with the waves. The deceit card is here, unfortunately. So somebody could be deceiving themselves about a situation. They could be deceiving themselves. Yeah, this is coming through strongly. Somebody could be deceiving themselves that everything is good, that they're happy, that everything is like stable. But it's like surface level. Everything's good on the surface here because you've got things like all tied up, like caught in the ruins here. It's like my recording stopped. Sorry. For some of you, if you are like, you know, some of you might be like happy, like truly happy, and you know in your soul, in your stomach, that you are, that your family is good, right? And if that's you, then this is not your message, okay? This message is coming through for those of you who are aware that your foundations are shaky. If you really look deep down inside yourself, you know that things aren't working out, that this is falling apart. Okay, so if you're happy, this is not your message. Don't get upset with me. Just leave it because it's a message for somebody else. Okay, and it's a message. I ask for the most important message that's going to come through, that's going to do the most good. So if you're in a happy family, a happy workplace, everything is fine, everything is good, then I don't need to tell you anything. Everything's good for you. Okay, but I'm talking now to the people who are struggling in a situation where things are going to pot. They're telling me, going to pot. So maybe somebody uses that term. So if this is you, again, like guys, just leave it if it's not your message. But if this is ringing true for you, what this is telling me is that there's a situation here. It's some kind of family, could be like workplace, could be literal family, but everything looks good on the surface, but it's not, because there's deceit underlying this. Somebody's could be deceiving themselves that everything's good, but it's not, or somebody's literally lying, be deceptive, possibly with money, right? You can see here there's something going on with money. This person has this like box. It's like they're trying to save money, but actually money's just spilling through the fingers. Somebody might be really, really bad with money. And here, these two cards tell me that within this relationship, there's some kind of codependency. You've got literally the attachment card where she's chained. Like you can see, she's chained to this post. She's wearing a mask, or she's looking at the mask. I think somebody is doing this reflection work. We have this reflection card where it's like actually they're looking at things a little bit more closely. They're aware that actually there are issues here because there's this chain and there's all tied up. It's like tied to some kind of situation. Deceiving yourself that things are fine with that mask there, but actually there's like a codependency. It could be a financial codependency. You can't leave a situation because you haven't got the finances. You are supporting somebody financially or being supported by somebody else financially, but they're giving me there's something rotten in the state of Denmark, which is a Hamlet quote. It's like there's something rotten there. It's like the foundation. They're showing me literally like wooden foundations, like struts in like a basement, like that are rotting. Like, you know, like what's that? Woodworm. Check if you've not got woodworm. Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if the devil card came out. This is like devil card energy here. But somebody, you know, you want the happy family. Of course, everybody wants that happiness. Anxiety over the situation. So again, you're going to know if this is your situation because you'll have the anxiety over it. If you're happy and everything's good, then it's not your situation. Anything else to tell me about? Oh, yeah. Okay, polar bear. We love the polar bear on this channel. Again, you could be dealing with a Pisces. Fate is there. Fate guiding you through. Compass. Compasses. People use boats on compasses on boats. You've got this world map here. Somebody may need to literally, like, raise the anchor and sail to a new situation. But it's like the, and again, this water imagery again, the polar bear here, he's been through the waters. He's a land animal. He's not meant to be in the water for too long. It's very, very cold in the water, but he's kind of built for it. He can swim out of the water. Again, it's like a ship going down, right? The ship going down, this person's like swimming to shore. But they've got a lot of, I'm sorry for this, but they've got a lot of blubber, this polar bear. Like, you know, somebody might have like, somebody might be quite, quite big, which actually provides more warmth in the cold water. I don't know like why that's coming through. I don't mean to be rude to anybody, but I have to say what comes through. Obviously the polar bear is kind of built for it. He's a strong swimmer. Somebody may be a strong swimmer. The polar bear kind of gives me like burdened energy, somebody who's kind of been burdened for a very, very long time. They've got a lot of perseverance, a lot of strength in perseverance, strength in being able to kind of keep on going through tough times. I really love the polar bear energy in this in my readings. I like it when it comes through. So there's something that you've been persevering with, like really swimming through those choppy waters, like trying to find land, trying to find the stability. Interestingly enough, false person is on the bottom of this deck. Again, if I'd have pulled that card, it would have been with the deceit card, but I've put it away. If it comes out again, it comes out again. So can you tell me, please, just anything, just tell me what you want to tell me. Mature man. So there could be a mature man in this situation. A mature man could be being deceptive. You may have an attachment to a mature man because of money. It's interesting as well that he has a globe with the map of the world there as well. Again, there's something definitely to do with like global travel, navigation, flight of the navigator. Somebody may have watched that recently. Oh, interesting as well, because I was picking up like somebody may be asking this man for money. That was going to be the next thing I said. And wealthy man is on the bottom here. There's some kind of codependency, I think, possibly between these two men. Take it as it resonates, leave it if it doesn't. It's like it could be the same man. There's a mature man who is wealthy, who people are going to for money. It's funny, I was posting like Godfather gifts the other day, and it's kind of, that's the imagery that they're showing me now. It's like he's there in his study at his desk in his library, people are going to him for money. It could be that this is your boss, right, like a CEO, and you have to go and ask for funding. It could be a library. You could work in academia and you have to go and apply for funding to somebody who's like a mature man, somebody with a lot of wisdom, with a lot of world experience, expertise. Could be some sort of global business. It could be that you're a wealthy man, or there's a wealthy man here who's in the situation, but this mature man is the one coming in asking for money. There could be some deception where somebody's like saying that they're saving money, but actually the money's slipping through the fingers, something like this. But it's a codependency, it's an attachment, and it's a financial attachment, is how I'm seeing this. Could be, they're showing me now a computer game called Detroit Become Human, where there's a very wealthy man in that game. I can't remember his name now. He's like an artist, very, very wealthy. And his son is kind of, he wastes money. He just wastes money. And he keeps coming to his dad for more money, and his dad actually finally says no. So you can, I don't want to kind of do too many spoilers with that. It's a really good game, definitely recommend playing it. Detroit Become Human. It's kind of a story based game, really, really good game. And I've actually kind of been thinking about playing it on my gaming channel, if anyone's interested in that. I don't know when, but it's a plan. Just a little plug there, to get a little segue into a plug to my gaming channel, Cinderella Plays Games. Four and five as well. Four and five, 1-3, 1-5, 5-15, 5-15. I don't know why that's not coming through. It could be time for somebody. 1-5-5. Perhaps you've seen the number 1-5-5 quite often. 13-15, 4.
So this could be the same person, or it could be two different people in the situation. Somebody could look wealthy, but it's a lie. Oh yes, oh yeah. They're kind of going, yes. Somebody could like put on this front that they're very, very wealthy, but actually they haven't got a lot of wealth. They're not actually very good with money. They've made some bad investments, possibly. Again, the adjudication card was underneath when I can you actually see that? I'm just checking my camera. The adjudication card was here. There may be some kind of court case that this person is in embroiled in, embattling. Sorry, these words are the way the words are coming through. Where it's like actually there's a threat to this person's wealth, because actually they've been deceptive. So they could be a judgment call here where this person could lose money, but there is some kind of money situation, codependency tied up. Like money, the money could be tied up in some sort of business. Like you have money, you look wealthy, but actually you haven't got any disposable income. All the money's tied up in something. Bad investments, attachments. Somebody may have given you bad advice about a financial situation. Okay, well, looks like I'm still going with these cards. May as well, right? So what's changing in the situation here for Taurus? The King of Coins. Yeah, somebody could very well be losing money here. You've got the King of Coins, which is the King of Pentacles. So somebody who has a lot of wealth, who has a good career, somebody in some kind of a position of tangible authority, and they are going into page energy. Pages are about having to rebuild, back to the drawing board, having to learn something new. Perhaps it's like learning a new craft. This person used to have it all. They used to be the godfather, but it's like now that they've actually, perhaps the world's moved on, and this person has to learn something new. They have to. There's a sense of like losing something tangible, losing something that could be losing money, but they have something to learn from it. They have to rebuild. Interesting. Yeah, really interesting. The gold figurines there. What needs to change? What needs to change in the situation? Can you tell me what needs to change in the situation, please? For Taurus, okay, Page of Cups just showed, but it went back in. That could be somebody needing to make an apology. It didn't come out though, so I'm going to keep going. High Priestess on the bottom there, intuitively knowing that there's. See that I always see that card. Always shows itself every time I pick up this deck. Can you tell me, please? Okay, sorry, I'm getting a bit disconnected. There may be a disconnect between you and another person. You need may need to apologize to recreate that connection. And there we go. And there's the Page of Cups again. Yeah, so somebody definitely needs to make an apology or an accept an apology. And it might feel like this is impossible. This is a card about something being impossible. But it's like there is a fish flying into that cup or flying out of that cup. It's like somebody's turned their back for a situation because it felt like it's perhaps too slow moving. But an apology could create a connection there. I don't know if these are meant to be in reverse. Oh, interesting. We've got the Two of Cups and the Ace of Cups and the Page of Cups and the Queen of Pentacles all in reverse. So I'm going to read it, them in reverse, but when I change the energy, I'm going to flip them upright. There's the Two of Cups in reverse. This is an imbalance in some kind of partnership. It was an unfair partnership. I'm going to show you in the upright as I describe it, an unfair partnership. There may be something where people have felt hurt, or there may be a literal injury, possibly that came through because of this relationship. This symbolizes healing for me. It also symbolizes Hermes, which is to do with like communication. Somebody may work in a medical field. So this is like in the reverse. It's like this situation wasn't balanced. It wasn't harmonious. People weren't seeing eye to eye. There was perhaps could have been over emotional, or there'd be a lack of emotions. Perhaps one person was giving more and one person was taking more. It wasn't balanced. So the Ace of Cups is about somebody offering love to somebody. Sorry about the bare bum. It's sculpture, it's art. Deal with it. So this person is like
this is, it's almost like this is the Knight of Cups who would come in offering, it could be offering help, offering support, offering love to someone. The Ace of Cups is like this opportunity for new love, new support, or a revival of a situation, but it wasn't coming, though this cup was not being offered, or it may have been over emotional. Again, it may have not been the right time. There's darkness here. It's a very dark card, maybe some confusion. And again, the Queen of Pentacles. I'm sorry to say this, guys, but the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. This could be a situation where somebody has left a marriage or left a long-term stable commitment or left a workplace. Take it as it resonates. It's something long-term to do with your finances, your tangibility, your security, your foundations in life. Somebody's turned the back here. You can see, like, it's almost like this is all scratched. There may have been a situation where people like could have been like actually fighting, or it could have been like fighting a court battle, fighting against those, you had like a contract card right up there, a commitment. It's like something's coming and struck. The temple has fallen down. The temple's fallen down. We told me that twice. The Queen of Pentacles in the upright is a beautiful energy. I'll talk about that in a minute. In the reverse, it's somebody who's greedy. It's somebody who values the tangible things in life. They value money more than anything else. They value the wrong things. They may have like that perfect Instagram life on the surface, but actually there's a lot going on that's like rotting underneath. She's jealous. She's possessive. She's greedy. She's again, it can be a man or a woman. It's just that the queens are more expressive about these things. She's not a nice energy at all. This could be the reason why somebody feels all tied up, or there's an attachment here, an unhealthy attachment here to somebody, to some kind of long-term commitment. So what needs to change? Let's flip these over into the upright. Oh, looks, she's beautiful now. So what needs to change in this situation? We need a relationship that is equal, a relationship here that is, it could be a business partner, could be a love interest, could be a family member. Take it as it resonates, leave it if it doesn't. There needs to be equality in this situation. People need to be able to see eye to eye, to do the healing, to work together with an equal give and take. It needs to be equal. There may be a wish here. Somebody may be wishing on a star for this to happen. So there needs to be equality within a relationship. This is a card about offering offering something emotionally. It could be a peace offering. Again, I was picking up on that apology, and with the dove there, it's like some sort of peace offering in this situation. Coming forward, offering an apology, offering support in a situation. There needs to be more emotion in this situation, more positive emotion, more support, more equality here. The Queen of Pentacles, again, it could be wife, boss, mother. She needs to be the change from the Queen of Pentacles in the reverse to the upright. It's like she's no longer turning her back in this situation. She's ready to offer you an opportunity or take some sort of tangible offer. She's somebody who's very, very nurturing, very abundant, very good at looking after the day-to-day tangible things in life, whether that be just keeping the business running smoothly, whether that's looking after house and home, looking after the children. She also takes very, very good care of herself physically. She's gonna brush her hair, get those haircuts. She's gonna put on a bit of makeup. Not necessarily, you know, I think she's quite earthy. She may just have a really good skincare routine, something like this. She wears nice quality clothes. She makes sure she eats well. So all these things. Take it as it resonates, leave anything that doesn't. But that's the, you can see the difference there between all those cards being in the reverse, into the positive there. I'm seeing, yeah, definitely some sort of apology there that could be made. Okay, let's quickly go. I'm just going to pull a card one after the other here. So I'm going to pull a card for your emotional space. What's going on emotionally? Oh, I just wanted one card. Got that Page of Cups there again. That's an apology. The Six of Wands is success. So an apology could be successful. There could be clarity coming in. I'm taking the Sun card. Could be clarity coming into a situation where there wasn't clarity before, shining a light on a situation. Some sense of loyalty there with the sunflowers. The child is on a horse. There's a sense of freedom, a sense of going with the flow. Again, a sense of just having fun in life. I think perhaps you just want to have fun. It's like you want to get on a horse and go riding on that beach, right? And just enjoy life a little bit. Four of Cups, again, is somebody not taking an emotional offer. You can see the cups are empty. She's literally offering him nothing. Again, this is kind of like a mother and child situation. And I did pick up on mother energy with the Queen of Pentacles there. Queen of Swords can be very, very cutting. She takes action to cut things out of her life if she needs to. She speaks her truth. She's logical. She can be a little bit cold, a little bit standoffish, but it's just her nature to be very, very logical. It doesn't mean she's not loving. It's just she might not show emotions as apparently as somebody else might. So I'm taking the Sun card as your main card for your heart space, your emotions, because I think you're trying to move towards happiness here. Happiness and perhaps freedom from a situation where it did feel like you were kind of tied up to it. Can I get a mental card? What's going on mentally? The Wheel of Fortune. This is, I think you are figuring out how to move the wheel yourself, how to change your look, how to, if there's been like a feeling of like being a bit misfortunate, it's like taking control of the wheel, steering the ship into calmer waters, but you're taking control of the Wheel of Fortune yourself, I feel, in this situation. Yeah, because you want your wish fulfillment, you want your abundance, you want your happiness there with the Nine of Cups. Okay, what's going on in the action space, please? What's going on in the action space, please, for Taurus? What's going on? I think we know what's going on in your action space, but we'll see what the cards have to tell us, if there's anything more. Don't drink too much. Don't drink too much with this liquor card in the reverse. Liquor. Interesting side message. Five of Cups. Five of Cups is about crying over spilt milk. Yeah, crying over spilt milk, like crying over the ruins of whatever this was for you, the situation that didn't work out. It's an emotional ruin, they're telling me. But what you don't see, if you just look up, there's actually somebody offering you this Two of Cups here. This Two of Cups is on the table. You just have to look up and see it. Yeah, but you're not at the moment. At the moment, you're still crying over the spilt milk there. Or actually, it could be that you're passing, leaving the situation. I do feel like somebody perhaps has been drinking too much to deal with this, the fallout of whatever this crumble, this storm was. Okay, so nearly done now. Let's get what kind of energy is Taurus in? Can you give me another idea of the energy that Taurus is in? These are not the best energies. There could be a crocodile in the water here. Again, crocodiles, the water is the natural space for this crocodile. They're very intelligent animals. They're very old animals as well. If we're talking about like ancestry, this is like somebody who's been around a very, very long time. They understand that how the tides change. But it's kind of like this lurking energy. There may be a sense of somebody lurking, just watching, keeping an eye on this egg. The black egg can mean an opportunity that it's almost like a dead end opportunity. It's something that it should be a golden egg, but it's not. It's a black egg. There's no luck there. But it can also mean intuition for me. Again, it's interesting that they're both scaled. So scaling something up, trying to scale something up. But again, I was picking up on perhaps somebody made a bad investment. It's a black egg investment. Black egg investments may be the name of a company. I don't know. It sounded like it. Like the crocodile's watching this black egg, and I'm getting the headache again, guys. Old energy regarding the black egg. Sometimes the black egg for me, no, they're not telling me. A bad investment. I'm pretty sure it's coming through as a bad investment today. So possibly you've made a bad investment. You feel like you've got this kind of like crocodile energy watching you. It's almost like waiting for you to make a move. I don't want to scare anybody. Like, again, I'm just going to say what comes through. I'm going to pull you an advice card because might as well, right? You can have all the cards, Taurus. I was going to try and do quick readings this week, but it's just, they wanted me to use a million decks, so I did. Here we go, the Fates. Yeah, look, you've got the Wheel of Fortune there.
I was talking about, it feels like fate is playing a hand here. If you've been acting with good karma, there's good karma coming for you. There's going to be justice in this situation. If you've done things by the book, if you've acted in high honor, then I feel like you know, fate is coming in to turn that wheel in your favor. If you've acted dishonorably, then I feel like if you've not done things by the book, or if people around you haven't done things by the book, they've acted dishonorably, I feel like there's going to be adjudication. There's going to be fate coming in here where it's going to balance out the situation and restore like the situation. I'm going to read a couple of the things from these because why not, my kids are in school, the cat's asleep, I've got the time. I'm reading the wrong card there. Well, it's funny that I opened it on flexible. There might be need to be flexible in the situation. Okay, back with you in a second. Okay, so this fate card means, the essential meanings, fate, karma, acceptance that there are things you cannot change and knowing what those things are. The Oracle's message. The Serenity Prayer sums up the meaning of this card. God, grant me, again, don't worry about if you are or are not religious, just take the message for the meaning of the message rather than any religious meaning. But just the meaning of the card. God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. There are things in your life that you will never have control over. Now, wasn't this the very opening message of this reading with the cat? It's funny how things come full circle. The conditions brought on by the evolution of the collective, by nature and by your past experiences may be fated, preordained by spirit for greater purpose that you cannot understand in this lifetime. It may not be in your cards to understand why certain events occurred, but you can accept the mystery and work with what those events and your current circumstances have to teach you. This is the wisdom contained in the Serenity Prayer. There you go, guys. So... totally everything I was saying confirmed there. Now there are further messages. You can see here there's a relationship message if you want to just pause and read those through. If you're dealing with a relationship, if you're dealing with money, there's a prosperity message there as well, and there's a protection message there too. So do read whatever you feel called to read. Leave anything that doesn't fit. So the 11 card by the book, but I'm going to pick it up because it's a nice card. You might want to look at it a bit more closely. Essential meanings, abiding by social rules, conformity, respecting cultural or family customs, universal laws. The Oracle's message, there's a hair on it. The universe works within a structure of divine laws and principles that provide a framework for human experience and evolution. The law of abundance, the law of prayer, the law of karma, the law of attraction, the law of thought, and the law of compensation, and the law of nature are only a few that are known. These principles create perfect order and operate with a kind of precision beyond human understanding. You've got two cards that are about things happening outside of your hands that are beyond your understanding. Even revolution has its place in universal law. Human beings, in turn, have their own laws and customs that vary from culture to culture, from family to family. Laws keep social order and govern behaviour, exactly what I was talking about again at the start of the reading, reflecting an instinctive understanding that harmony is important. There is a time to learn these laws and conform to them, rather than being the rebel and flouting them. When this card appears, submit to structure and follow the rules, even if they seem to make no sense. Release resistance, for universal laws will correct any disharmony. I'm going to run out of time. Open your eyes to those universal laws and it will be easier to go by the book at this time. Okay, hopefully I can just get these in here for you to pause. But I'm going to say goodbye, Taurus. Goodbye and good luck with that, because I am just about to run out of time. But I hope that is helpful to you. There we go. Bye bye, guys.